Hello, Xerxes.
Hello, Geeta. How are you?
I am awesome. How are you?
Good. I'm very excited for our webinar today.
Well, yes. And, you know, before we get started on all the, you know, exciting things with the numbers that you're going to be sharing, wanted to definitely say that I have two suggestions for everybody that is listening and our community. The first thing is that we're probably in this for a while, and we all know that. So please don't watch the news more than 10 to 15 minutes a day, please. And that goes for everybody. Let's limit our news watching time to no more than 15 minutes a day. And I have something, Xerxes, I know you don't have kids, but this is something I'd like to share for everybody just in the community. Anybody that has a child whose birthday is coming up, you know, it's a bummer because they can't really celebrate the way they want to. But what you can do is have some of your child's closest friends do a drive-by and wish your child a happy birthday. So social distancing, drive-by, honking the horns, and wishing them a happy birthday.
I don't think that's just limited to kids.
Actually, yes, you're right. You're right. Why did I say it? That is, you know, so true. So yes, I stand corrected. That is for anybody that might be celebrating a birthday. So no news or limited news, and celebrate a birthday. Have drive by your friend's home, adult or kid, honk and wish them a happy birthday in style. Okay, that is sure to cheer everybody up. So back to our call for today. Just wanted to go over the numbers, and this is to keep things on a positive note. As much as we're reading all kinds of things and hearing things, and no doubt there's been an impact and things have changed with regards to how real estate is being done, but Xerxes, in the last 1 week, there were 1,651 homes and condos that were listed for sale in the Greater Toronto Area, right? And 478 of those sold.
Yeah.
And that's actually up from the last 2 weeks in March. So 478 sales in the last 7 days. You know, so those are numbers that are worth mulling over, just so you know that there is activity taking place.
Absolutely. Things are developing every day, and it's important to look at the big picture and also look for the positive.
So, yeah, absolutely. And I know you've got some exciting numbers and graphs and things that you want to share, which I'm sure a lot of people will be very interested in.
Yeah. So, what I'd like to do at this moment is just talk about what, I mean, we've now seen the effects. You know, in the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about what the effects would be. We've now seen the effects. I mean, given the amount that the virus has spread and, you know, the unfortunate number, which is the deaths, we've seen the effect that it's had on several different markets. And we're here to support people through the real estate market. And the effect that it's had is that we saw a huge distinction between the first half of March and the second half of March. Mm-hmm. So the first half of March, we were up a significant amount. We were up 49%, which was unbelievable year over year. From last March to this March, we had close to 50% increase in sales. Mm-hmm. However, in the second part of March, we had 12% less than what happened the second half of last March. So March is a critical month because it's the start of the spring market. We actually see the start in February, but you know, we're full on in the spring market.
I mean, but relatively speaking, just putting it into perspective, yes, it was a drop from the last 2 weeks of March in 2019, but even with that 15% drop, I mean, it was over 3,300 homes that still sold.
Oh, so that was my very next point, which was the overall number has been a positive number with regards to sales and with regards to price point. So we are tracking, we've kept our pulse on the market every single day, I mean, sometimes multiple times a day.
I know.
So we're very much in tune as to what's going on, what is selling, how long are things taking to sell. So I wanted to share some interesting stats. So the first thing I wanted to share, I mean, for the people who were on a couple of weeks ago or saw our webinar a couple of weeks ago, we had Sean from TD who was on here. And he was telling us about what interest rates were doing and where things were going. So I got an update from him. So the five-year fixed right now on a 25-year amortization is 2.84. And a five-year variable is 2.45. And then on a 30-year, it's 2.94 for a fixed and 2.55 for a variable. So still incredible. I mean, really incredible rates compared, because we're looking at everything over a year. I mean, Gita, we've talked about this. Real estate is one of those things that it's wait, as buy real estate and wait, right? Yes. So yes. Normally when we tell our investors as well regarding real estate, it's a 5, 7, 10 year investment. So even if we just look at a year, which is still a very short period of time, it's still done extremely well.
And you know, to that point, I mean, investors, yes, but people, first-time home buyers or people that are looking to move because of life circumstances and they have to make that move right now, I mean, the same applies to them. Likely, you're not moving into your next home for a year, you know, unless there's something else that comes up. So regardless of whether investor or sub or end user, you're staying in your home 5 to 7 years at the minimum. You're only looking at an upward, you know, an upward movement.
Right. So like we've said, like you've said, like I've said, like the rest of Team Rajpal has said, we want to help people when it's right for them. And it's important for people to move when it's right for them for various life circumstances, for whatever reasons those might be. So I'm just going to give people an idea of what's happened in the first week of April. So here we are, and I've broken it down for houses and condos. So from April 1st to April 7th, what has happened on the Toronto Regional Real Estate Board? So this includes all the suburbs as well. So the number of sales is 273 for houses and 123 for condos. So approximately 400, like you rightly said. The average days on market is still amazing. It's still only just 2 weeks. Wow. So that's the average days on market. Mm-hmm. And the average house, the approximate average house prices are 800,000 for houses and 572 for condos.
And that, so that's not the average price for a home in the GTA today. That is just the average sale price of these homes that sold, correct?
Correct. Yes. Yeah. So it's okay. Just, it's the 273 homes that sold. The approximate average price was about 800,000. Mm-hmm. And for the condos, it was around 575. So still great prices. I mean, looking from last year to this year, same timeline, still incredible prices, but overall it's doing very well given the circumstances.
Yeah. And one thing to, you know, make note of as well is that the activity, naturally, that we're seeing the bulk of the activity under that million price point. That's where the bulk of the activity is taking place.
Yes.
So not, it's not to say that outside of that million range there isn't, but the bulk of it is moving under the million mark.
Yes. So in any good market, in any market in general, we've seen the million price point in the Toronto market has been that threshold point, you know,
for the, it's the average price point.
Exactly. So yeah. Under the average is moving really well. Properties are still moving, and that's a good sign. You know, but the next thing I wanted to talk about, you were talking about like what has sold and what hasn't sold. So one of the things I wanted to mention over here was how many thousands of units, these are seasonally adjusted annual rates, but we're looking at things, like I said, over a large timeline, right? So we want to look at the last 20 years and we see a smooth upward trending line, a very healthy line. I mean, there's obviously a lot of noise in there, but we're looking at where we are right now. And given that everything that's happening, we're not in a bad position, again, for the people who need to move, right? So I just wanted to show this to people as to where we were towards the end of March. So the numbers are out, and So as we mentioned, this market is for the people who need to move. So that's very important for clients to gain perspective on the grand scheme of things, which the chart expresses. So we need to see an upward trending line, which is what has happened over the last several years. Mm-hmm. So if you've owned your home for the last 5 years, 7 years, we still see that the average price point is higher. The next chart I wanted to talk about is the active listing. So how many listings are on the market? It's important for people to understand that right now there's less number of listings, but there's also less number of buyers, which is, it's simple economics, demand and supply, right? So with regards to that, the supply is falling, but so is the demand, which is keeping prices stable. So in the terms of keeping prices stable, we have something called the seller's market, a balanced market, and a buyer's market. Mostly people talk about a seller's market or a buyer's market, but a balanced market is very interesting as well. So in Toronto, at least, we recognize that what is, when 60% of the homes are selling, it's a seller's market. If 40% of the homes are selling, up to, it's a buyer's market. And in between there is a balanced market. So that's where we're going to see things settle. Like we're seeing a plateau where it's going to come down. And then over time, as things improve, as the economy improves, that's going to start taking off again. So,
and I think as well, just to jump in there, what is really important, because when you put it in perspective, now you're looking for the last 20 years. And when we look at small periods of time and you're looking at January to March and everybody is just following that roller coaster and traveling along with it emotionally, but you put things into perspective. And if you go back to the time, whether it was the 2008 6-month dip or it was the dip that we saw right away after the foreign tax was implemented right in 2017, then those dips, and if you remember that time, it seemed like it was never going to come to an end. But you look at the flow just over the last 20 years and the general trend, like you're saying, the general trend even after the dips is upward.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And typically what I call our bounce back time is once a crisis has happened. I mean, granted, we've not had a health pandemic to this degree. So it's yet to be seen.
And we can't compare government regulations and other specific to the market conditions to what we're experiencing right now. And quite honestly, I think both of us and all of Team Rajpal would say that, here's what everything is as of today. This is what it is as of today. And, everything is changing week by week. And so our job is really just to keep on top of where the movement is happening. And this is with relation to something that is outside of everybody's control.
Exactly. And that's exactly it. So I think you hit the nail on the head over there. So with regards to what you were just talking about, I mean, different government interventions, different government rules that came into play, this chart really expresses that. And we're comparing Toronto and Vancouver, the two hottest real estate markets, I would say, over the last, majority of the decade. We've seen...
So blue is Toronto, okay.
Blue is Toronto, gray is Vancouver. Mm-hmm. So they have marked out over here with BC and Ontario when they put in certain rules and what that did to the market. And you can see over here in the end of the last quarter of 2018, I'm not sure if you can see my mouse, but essentially the last quarter of 2018 is overall when Toronto overtook the Vancouver market. Mm-hmm. And that includes houses and condos. And that's talking about the price index. So we saw in the last quarter of 2018, that's when Toronto moved ahead of Vancouver and significantly moved upwards compared to Vancouver. But then we saw in 2019, halfway through 2019, the Vancouver market started to move upwards, but Toronto kept moving upwards. So overall, we've got, again, gain perspective, look at things on a larger scale. People are focused on what's happened in the last 60 days. But focus on what has happened in the last, 60 months, I would say, because that's really where the difference is as far as prices are concerned. So that's with regards to the chart. The second thing I wanted to talk about today was what has happened with regards to the new rules which the Ford government made further clamp down on essential services. So one of the markets that got affected was construction workers. So what that means is to our clients out there who purchased pre-construction condos that are coming due this year, and we have quite a few that are slated to come in this year, we're seeing, we're getting letters from the builders called unavoidable delays. And basically the fact that this has been labeled a pandemic falls under what Tarion deems a unavoidable delay. So what does that mean? So let's say, for example, your condo was due to come in August 31st. And after which, if it hadn't been delivered on that date, the builder had penalties to pay maybe. What that means is, let's say that this continues, this unavoidable delay continues for 30 days. Well, that all that does is that shifts that timeline to September 30th. So whatever the delay is, that's what the timeline is extended by. So that's basically where things are at with pre-construction.
Question on that. Yeah. How does that impact? So somebody, I've got, you know, so one of our many clients that has invested in a project and there's now there's that delay. Does that, is there any impact to them, you know, even just from a mortgage standpoint? I remember you were talking about something where they'd have the ability to hold something for a longer period of time.
Right. So when, normally when you apply for a mortgage, you can apply 100 and you can hold your rate for 120 days. But when, what that means is, let's say I'm going to the bank today, I foresee myself purchasing a house. I need to have signed the contract to purchase the house within 120 day timeline of me getting approved by the bank for them to hold that rate. Mm-hmm. But with pre-construction, we've technically signed the contract. We've already purchased the property. So there's certain banks that will actually look at that and say, okay, well, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the property today and we're going to do an appraisal on the property today and we're going to qualify you for a full mortgage today. So if any changes occur between now and the time of you getting the mortgage, you're not going to be affected too much by the fact that you already have been qualified for the mortgage and the appraisal was done on the day that you applied for the mortgage. So let's say with TD, for a fact, I know you can apply 2 years ahead of time. So I don't think, depending on what institution you go to, I know Scotiabank does it 4 months in advance, but TD, for example, does it for 2 years in advance. So it's important to find the right institution. I'm not saying one is better than the other. I'm just saying that they have different rules and regulations when it comes to looking at pre-construction condos. Mm-hmm. But I would say that most people who bought a pre-construction condo in 2015, 2016, majority of them have done extremely well. Even today, looking back at things, it has improved significantly with regards to the values.
So just switching gears a little bit, like for somebody that's now a first-time buyer, and I know that we're doing something very, very special and specific to first-time buyers who are not always as excited, Xerxes, to hear about all the investors you talk about. So though mind you, some of the first-time buyers are coming in as investors. They're choosing to continue to rent, and they're simply becoming landlords. So. Yeah. There is something really special coming up for first-time buyers. That's next Friday.
Correct.
But just for somebody that is listening in, and we're getting so many people going back after the fact to listen to the recording, and we're getting great feedback on it. There, a question could be, I mean, because there's so much uncertainty in the market in general, that why wouldn't I wait? Like, should I wait for a month or 2 months to start looking?
So, I mean, Geeta, our clients who worked with us have heard the term, we don't have a crystal ball. And we don't know when this is going to turn around. We don't know what impact it might have. People who locked into a mortgage rate 4 weeks ago are seeing very different rates than what is available today. I mean, the mm-hmm. rate has gone up 0.3%, 0.4%. Mm-hmm. So even though prices might be slightly lower, we've got to look at affordability. I mean, unless you're paying cash. And if you're paying cash, good for you. honestly. Yeah. But with regards to the majority of the market, which are mortgage holders, we've got to look at what that monthly payment is, right? So we've got to see where is the market at, and does this timeline work for you? That's the main thing. We've got to look at, does this timeline look for you? Is there opportunity in the market? I think that's the question being asked right now. Is this a good time from the point of view of, is there opportunity in the market? Absolutely. In every market, there is opportunity depending on which side of the fence you're on. But in the long run, I will say this. We have seen over the last several years, over the last two decades, that in the grand scheme of things, as long as you purchase real estate and you're not squeezed to sell it, you typically do well in the Toronto real estate market.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
And 1 or 2 months is not going to make a world of a difference.
Yeah. And I think it's also important to talk about, like, so for people that are considering getting into the market and, you know, thinking, okay, well, you know, we're thinking about waiting. We're thinking about getting into the market. What we're saying is, even if you don't know what you're waiting for, right? So if you're going to be waiting and watching, what is it exactly that you're waiting for right now? And this is, again, the advice has not changed. If there's a life circumstance that requires you to actually go ahead and sell or make a move, then you need to do it. I mean, just yesterday, I had a call from somebody that is listing their home for sale in Burlington, and they have to move, and they are looking. They were looking at one of the condos that we have available in Oakville, and we are setting up a time for them to walk through that property. It's going to be done in a safe manner, keeping social distancing in mind, making sure that everybody is protected. So one thing that we're doing to that effect for our sellers and our listings is there's a health questionnaire that is being sent out to the agents who are bringing in buyers, or to buyers that are calling us directly on our listings. And they do have to go through and answer that health questionnaire. They do have to follow certain precautions before coming to the property. For some people, and I know you did that recently, Xerxes, you actually put in an offer for a client and you had a condition on the viewing. Is that what you did?
Right. So what it was we had the floor plan in place and we had the pictures. So we put in an offer, and apart from the regular conditions, we put in a condition where within 24 hours of the deal being accepted, we would actually come in and actually look at the property. Believe it or not, for the first time. So, you know, I think the point that we're driving home is that there's people who need to do things. Mm-hmm. And for those people, we have innovative ways to make it happen. Mm-hmm. And we're here, we're still considered an essential service, hence the reason why we're on here, and we're still working every single day. We're here to help anybody who really needs to move. If you have any questions or you're preparing a move sometime this year, it's now more than ever to get in touch with your agents, get in touch with us earlier so that we can set up the right timelines in place, because things are taking a little longer. That's the fact.
No, you're absolutely right. So somebody that's thinking, oh, well, my new build is not closing, I'm not getting it until September, October, I've got time. No, this is the time. This is the time to contact us, because it's going to take time to actually get prepped for this market and to do things a little bit differently. And so to that effect, like, we've got a couple of other professionals that we are going to be bringing to these calls. So this Friday, there will be no Q&A, even though everybody's already at home. It's just trying to keep that reminder. It is Good Friday, so there's no call on Friday. Next Wednesday, we are actually going to have a professional home stager that is going to join us again, 12:30 to 1 next Wednesday. And as a reminder, we are sending out the recording of all of these Q&A sessions. I'm getting excellent feedback. Just today I spoke to 10 to 12 people that are like, oh my God, we're looking at the recording after the fact. Very valuable information. So thank you for that. And next Wednesday is a home stager that is going to answer questions about what you can do to prep your home and how are they doing things differently. They are not an essential service. However, they can do a virtual walkthrough of your home with you so that you know exactly what needs to be done before we get your home in the market. And next Friday is, like I mentioned before, a very, very special session for first-time home buyers, and not only first-time home buyers, but buyers that do not have $1 million budget, because that seems to be the average price point. This is not for investors. It is for first-time home buyers, and that is next Friday. So we will be sending information out for that as well. And in the coming weeks, we are going to have a home inspector online. We're going to be bringing back mortgage specialists from Scotia again, TD, and other banks as well. So just a lot of great information that we hope you're going to find helpful. And if there are any questions that you feel that are not being addressed on these calls, email them in to us at info@teamrajpal.com or give us a call. Each and every one of us is available and working and ready to make it happen for you.
Well, thank you so much, Geeta. And it's been a very interesting time, but I can honestly say I'm really excited for next week's sessions, especially the first-time homebuyers. I'm really hoping people can make the most of that opportunity. So stay tuned.
And we're not going to say too much, but it is an opportunity. So, if you miss out on it, don't tell us. We didn't tell you. So.
All right. Take care.
Stay safe, everybody. Hey, and we're going to be emailing out all those graphs that you sent?
Yeah, we can definitely do that.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome.
Perfect.